My name's Joe, and I've been living out of my 2011 Jeep Wrangler.
I travel the states looking to hike, fish, and camp wherever I can.
So if you like any of this content, consider subscribing
so we can make sure we keep the show on the road.
But right now, let's get to it, baby.
All right, so I just got off the Grand Canyon, got out of there. What we're doing is we're kind of heading back towards Flagstaff. There's a hike or trail on the way to Flagstaff. We're probably 50 miles away, but I'm starting to notice there's my alternator's not really charging my battery. So I noticed this wire, it's a bad connection, it's really hot. So that could start a fire. So we need to get that replaced.
So we gotta figure that out and be careful
that we don't start a fire in the engine. But, so we'll hit that hike, then maybe we'll try to repair that.
Really cool, wow.
Look at that.
Oh man, I am sore. See the fuse, yeah, everything's just melting under there. Oh crap.
So this line is charged to my MPPT charge controller, which is then charged to the battery, but I don't think this would be a live wire. Maybe I should DC it just in case. So that's the one that goes directly in here. So it shouldn't go back out this way, but we'll DC it just in case.
That is so fried up. I don't know if I can maybe get all this crap off and salvage this thing. Because if not, I don't think I have another one.
I'm not gonna be able to reuse this terminal. The crimp is too tight. I'm not gonna be able to open it up. So what we'll do is we'll just go without it right now. So we just don't have main battery, but luckily, how I run this thing is I've got this Jackery as well. It's a small one, it's their 240 with this solar panel. So I can always charge up. So we're still charging right now from the main battery, from whatever's left of my main battery. And I consider this my main battery. The 200 amp hour charges from the starter battery, charges this up. And then I pretty much run everything through this battery just in case. This thing is awesome. Jackery, you should sponsor me if you ever see this video. All right, this is gonna be the first hike since the Grand Canyon and I'm still sore. The Grand Canyon ended up being like 9 to 10 miles. And then doing all that elevation change. If you didn't see that video, you should go watch it.
Time to really bring the energy, you know what I mean? Jacked up.
Stuff is quality. I love this stuff. If you want to sponsor me, please, I need money. One scoop, two scoop, red scoop, blue scoop. All right, for those of you who don't know, when I do trail running and stuff, I take it really serious, really do a good job and push ourselves. So it's not a time for ha-has, hee-hees, or laughing or anything. I think it's time to, you know, bear down and get after it. So stupid. Pretty cool.
Wow.
Place is pretty cool. Not a lot of effort, but a lot of reward on this hike. So highly recommend. Oh wow. Look at this. All right, let's go. Home sweet home, baby. Here's the plan. I don't have any more water. My battery's dead. I need to fix it. I haven't had a shower in 7 days. So I need to get into Flagstaff. So I think what we're gonna do, just jet into Flagstaff, figure out my situation right now. Fix everything, reset, shower, have a good time. You know, the huge. Live life, baby. It was fun. Forgot to bring you guys. Let's get out of here. Okay, we're at Walmart. We need to pick some stuff up. I gotta fix the battery. There's an Anytime Fitness right behind this Walmart here, so we're gonna kind of chill, relax. What I like to say is just reset, and then we'll figure out what we're gonna do. Okay, that's the plan, Stan. Chop, chop. Gonna be able to tell immediately if it's gonna be working and actually charging the battery, but as long as we get alternator to come on, that's good enough for now. And we're on. All right. Oh, first shower since I did Sedona running, Grand Canyon running, and then that Red Trail Mountain run. That was probably a solid 5 days of no shower. I was just driving east to Albuquerque, or in that direction, and I found this. Need to stop, grab some gas real quick. Hello, hello, hello. Ah, crap. Hello. Oh, that's creepy. There's like a person there. Stopping to get gas, huh? So it used to be two arrows, but apparently someone knocked down the other one. This is wild. So this is a couple exits down from the Twin Arrows, and this is an old gas station. And apparently somewhere around here there's some like cool native death caves is what they call them. Wow. creepy. Doable. Look at the butte.
Apache Death Cave. Sign me up. Let's go. So the Hopi, Navajos, and Apaches are among the tribes who lived in two guns. The Navajos and Apaches often fought each other and used the Diablo Canyon to seek refuge and as a launch attack point. Such was the case of the battle that ended in the area of two guns, which is known as the Apache Death Cave. The battles between the Navajos and the Apaches were constant. The group of Apache warriors hid in a cave located in two guns. In 1878, they attacked a Navajo camp and murdered everyone with the exception of three Navajo girls who were taken in as prisoners. The Apaches not only murdered the Navajos whom they raided, they also looted the area. When the Apaches attacked another Navajo camp, the Navajo warriors went to Canyon Diablo and saw hot air coming out of the ground. After taking a closer look, the Navajos discovered that there was a cave and that the raiding Apaches were hiding in it with their horses. The Navajos began to throw burning dry wood into the cave. The Apaches then slit the throats of their horses in an attempt to put out the fire after they ran out of water. The Apaches then slit the throats of their own horses in an attempt to put out the fire after they ran out of water. When the Navajos found out from an Apache who came out of the cave that the three Navajo girls were murdered, they threw him into the fire and murdered 42 Apaches in the cave. The cave became known as Apache Death Cave. Pretty cool. Sounds like a pretty good place to camp. Cool to drive up in there, but I'm not going to out of respect for this place. I don't need any bad juju coming my way, but dang, this is cool. Big ol'. During the winter of 1879 to 1880, Billy the Kid and his outlaw gang hid in the ruins of a stone house in Corral on the west rim of the Diablo Canyon, across from the two guns. So I guess the roundhouse or tower in two guns served as a Texaco gas station in the 1930s. There is your Texaco gas station, my friends. All right, so this is the plan. Don't know if I'm gonna do much tonight. Sun going down, it's about 7 o'clock, maybe 7:30. We're still heading east though, after this. This is a cool area. Well, we are near the Apache Death Cave. So some of you are wondering, you know, you gonna be all right out there? We're gonna find out. We're really gonna find out. You know, Apache Death Cave, pretty cool and all, pretty spooky, very spooky. You know, sometimes being out here, especially the remote Southwest, you know, sometimes there's not a lot of people and some weird old boys get to doing weird old. So you never know. Absolutely beautiful out here. Highly recommend. Oh, there were a ton of people. By the way, if you do come visit, there were a ton of people that went to the bridge. They would park back there where I was, went to the bridge, didn't go past the bridge, and missed the best part. So if you do come here, was it Two Guns, to see the Death Caves and then also the old Texaco station and all these homes and everything, or old buildings, make sure you go across the bridge, because this is the best part right here. This main building, and then behind the building that I showed you guys already, you don't want to miss it. If I wasn't living on the road, I would never have seen this. And I keep saying this, I don't know if anyone's seen any of my other videos, but you know, there's give and takes to this this lifestyle. Living out of a Jeep, yeah, it's uncomfortable. It gets gross, it gets dirty, it gets filthy, but I've seen a lot of the United States. I'm not gonna say most, but I've seen a lot of it. I've done way more in the past year and a half than I ever would have thought of had I not, you know, taken upon this lifestyle. But we need to make sure this lifestyle continues as long as we enjoy it. So if you guys are watching this, like this, think about subscribing. We'll try to make this like a thing. I think it would be cool to keep going. But I mean, I just saw this on the map and it sounded awesome. It sounded crazy, and turns out it's pretty badass.